many people know about Watercookies. So I was anxious to take this opportunity to give you a short synopsis, because many of you mentioned around the table family, friends, ethics, babies, and blooms, all of which are affected in one way or another by water. In front of you, you will see a beautiful yellow canoe. This is part of my outreach. By the end of this little presentation today, I'm hoping that every one of you fellow members can help us. We're trying to grow. I don't know everything. I know a little bit about a lot, but enough to get me in trouble. And I know around this table you're all professionals, and I need to understand what the community needs from your viewpoint when it comes to educating families about the value of clean water in Western North Carolina. Specifically, our focus is the United States of America. However, we're local, and we've only been a nonprofit for 7 years. I have a James Taylor kind of a personality where I'm sort of lackadaisical and relaxed and like to make friends. But I also have a plan, and the plan is to help America know that we have concerns here. Our bridges are falling. Our water systems are having sediment like twice a day. We have things that are happening, and our goal as a small board, a small amount of people as we're growing, is to instill a seed of encouragement to learn about clean water. The very first focus that we do is we outreach to kids K through 5 here in Western North Carolina, Buncombe County and Hendersonville County specifically right now, because we're small. We can't eat the big elephant yet, but we plan on eating that big elephant for us to short of water. So we outreach to kids locally. Today I'll be at Kids in the Creek with some other volunteers and Mountain True, along with DER. We are going to be out into the waters, digging up sediment, finding out the fish are there. Because without clean water, you can't have fish. Without fish, you can't have food. Without food, you can't survive. So it all comes down to the Watercookies project, and that's what we're doing today. That's why I'm dressed like this. Having said that, the reason I got into this was, I'm so sorry, please tell me your first name.
Dan.
Dan?
Yeah.
You hit it right in the head. I wanted to let people know why I'm doing what I'm doing, not because of me, but because of you, your family, your loved ones, the elder people who definitely need clean water, because in hospitals or in senior citizen places, if you don't have clean water, you can't run your business. This is all important stuff here. So 7 years ago, I was in Alaska, and I was fortunate enough to meet Inuit and Yupik Indians there. They were sustainable living families. 300 people in this particular part of Alaska. My daughter was a teacher there, and that's why I went to visit. And I had no idea what was going to happen. And what really happened was that I noticed that a lot of the junior high school students had bobcat teeth. Now, I don't know if that's the right word. I'm not a dentist, and that's why I say, well, sticky notes is hopefully will be able to help me at the end of this. But these kids didn't have proper dental hygiene, and I found out that part of the reason was because the mothers, when they were pregnant, and to your point, they had poor nutrition. So I came back to the lower 48 thinking, I'm retiring from Marriott World. This is America. Why aren't these young women and men understanding that nutrition is so important? To your point too, Anna Marie. So I came home and I sat in my house when I was living in Puff's Head, and I thought, what can I do? I'm only one person. I don't have a background in philanthropy or anything of that nature, but I knew I was retiring, and I knew that I could make a difference, and I knew that other people would help. So what has happened 7 years later, we test marketed in South Carolina. We wanted to come up with something that people would be instantly inquisitive about. We wanted people to say, what's a water cookie? Do you bake cookies? Look, that's exactly what we wanted. Because I don't bake cookies. You don't even want to eat my food. It's pretty awesome. I figured out a way. So we did some research and found out that the average family in America buys 2.5 boxes of cookies a week.
Wow.
So the tune of $11.25. So I thought, well, okay, everybody loves cookies, I guess, and they're eating them at parties, they're buying them from the Girl Scouts. They're doing things that, you know, we take cookies everywhere we go. There's the market. How can I tap into a cookie market? Well, the idea was if I could later, as we move forward, have a sponsor such as a national brand, and pennies from the purchases of that cookie went into our foundation, We provide scholarships to kids going into the environmental sciences. Right now, we have four scholarships that we're looking to award to a senior in one of these, four of these high schools, actually, in Buncombe County and Hendersonville County. We have them. We're just now starting to approach people. So if you guys know of any educational outreach person or anybody who would be interested in talking to me about these scholarships, we had an event last year. We surpassed our goal. We're now going towards our next goal, which is going to be 22 $1,000 scholarships, bless you, in 2019, which brings me to the next part. I have a counter events of what we're doing, and I know I talk fast because I'm from Spain, but I only have 10 minutes, but I wanted to share with you guys some events that maybe you will be interested in attending, bringing your family. Maybe you will be interested in learning with yourself about the water in your community. So if you have a pencil, you might want to jot some of these down. The very first one is, well, today, Rugby Middle School from 9 until 2:30 will be playing in the water today, tomorrow, and Thursday. There's 3 days of that, and it's at the Mills River Library. Second thing is, let's see what we got here. June 7th, Thursday, it's a farm worker event. They've had 4 9-outs for us so far to amount about $800, which is just people going and having a hamburger. 10% comes back to our nonprofit, which goes into the general fund, which is everything that we're talking about right now, the marketing that we do, everything's volunteer, printing. So farm worker is our biggest income generator right now, I guess we would say. So if you guys like farm worker, please attend that on June 7th. We also have two lunch and learns. Who here has been to a water treatment facility plant to see about your drinking water? Great. Who's been to the facility where it's wastewater? Yeah. Great. Well, then you guys can still come. But on June 14th at 2 o'clock, we have the Hendersonville Wastewater Lunch and Learn, coffee and equals first. This will be on our website. I'm talking a lot, so you can see if you want to go. That's June 14th. We also have on May the 10th, back at the Mills River plant at 2 o'clock. On the Mills River plant is on 191. That's drinking water. Another one to go. And this is family friendly. You can't bring kids, by the way. There are steps, but you can do it. It lasts about an hour and a half, depending on your where, you know, what you'd like to learn. They're great guys. So there's the most important ones, but here's a really cool one. We have two fundraisers this year. Outreach is important. Obviously, you're all parents, uncles, aunts, or something that has to do with children in some capacity. But we wanted to have an event that would encourage adults. So we're having a no water, no beer, no wine, no life campaign coming out. We're just starting to meet. On April 23rd, the booth goes from 5:30 to 7:30. There will be people who have been invited to come who'd like to be involved in some capacity to be a part of this program, because we are anticipating having 10 restaurants, 10 breweries, 10 sponsors for this project that we'll hopefully pick out all in September. So April 23rd is a big fun kickoff for us at Bluegoes. So that's our first fundraiser. We hope that we can make the money that we're trying to make. Going into a blue tie event, which is the same as a black tie event. So in November, between Thanksgiving and Christmas, we will have another event to be held properly at Bluegoes, because blue tie and Bluegoes go together. Caribbean Cowboy will be in the band, and we will have silent auction at the same time. So there are two big fundraisers for the year. That's it. We don't do a lot of fundraising. I wish we did more fundraising, but we're little, we're tiny, but we're doing fun things. So that's the Water Cookie Project, educating kids about the value of clean water, providing scholarships to seniors going into the environmental sciences, and making people aware that here in America, we need to pay attention as well. Because we care about their worlds and wells, of course, but locally, we need to take care of our own. So that's what we're trying to do. In a snapshot, that's everything I wanted to share this morning. In case anyone has any questions. Yes?
What's your background?
My background is in hospitality. So I don't have a nonprofit background. I come from marketing with Marriott Corporation. So I travel around the country working with 4 and 5-star resorts. I retired about 10 years ago, and that's when I went to 2007, went to the Alaska time with my daughter. And I saw this, and I just had to do something. This is my full-time gig. Public speaking, I've done public speaking in the past, and I just felt that maybe if I was blessed enough to care about things that everyone should care about, maybe I could plant that seed and get around some folks who haven't come to their office. So that's also.
So some people would say that our drinking water system has a lot of challenges and troubles that, you know, are harming
contact if you want to put your name, please do. I'll do that. And I have your price. anybody wants a Ford prize.
Turn down.
Let me do one more thing. I met Helen a long time ago. She was doing an outreach program out at the North Mills Farm, and she and her team made it so fun to learn about water as we were doing sampling and the fun stuff that she was doing. So when she's out there with the kids and her team of volunteers, she makes it so much fun. So go out there with your kids, your grandkids, your nieces and nephews, the neighbors. Bring them. Thanks, everyone.
Awesome. Joe, you've been a lot of fun.
No,
Welcome, Dan Martin.
So, Dan, this is great. Guess what you have?
Oh,
a six pack. Oh, just water.
Yeah.